Oh, good fish. Good fish.
That's good fish.
All right, so welcome to an absolutely gorgeous day on the Long Island Sound. Amazing conditions. It's pretty much an Indian summer going on because it's 70 degrees and it's early November, November 8th, 9th or something. So yeah, it's pretty amazing. It's great blackfishing to be able to blackfish in November like this. You know, I think these fish are starting to move out of the shallows. So today, I'm gonna be trying more like 40 or 50 feet of water. And yeah, we'll see what happens. You know, I've done decent at this spot in the past, but not a whole lot of keepers. It's always tough to get keepers. And yeah, we'll see what happens. I'm just pretty excited. Got a lot of green crabs. And we'll try to get some underwater as well. It's pretty much the routine. I'm eager to see what the bottom looks like. I may have to put a light down. Because 40, 50 feet, I usually can't get any footage to come out, so we'll see. All right, catch back in. About blackfishing, the best thing you can do is your first drop, you start feeling life right away. And that's what's happening right now, so pretty happy about that. There's really no current, so you know, I'm not really anchored. Whoa. Not like anchored with that much line out because I know I'm gonna swing once the current changes. Nope. Let's get fresh crab. Throw it up current a little bit. In a socket, out of socket. Bombs away. We got something tiny. Maybe a sea bass. That's blackfish. Alright, so a little guy. But at least they're there. Probably just stay here till bite shuts off or something, but it's a promising first couple minutes. Ooh. This is either foul hooked or a good fish. Probably foul hooked. Yeah, foul hooked. It's just a bunch of shorties down there, huh? As soon as I feel the weight come up, I set the hook. These are all really tiny, actually. I think it took it all. Thank you.
bigger one. Still no keeper though. Snagged. It's like the one of the few times I've ever gotten snagged out here. I wonder if I still have bait. Probably not. Oh, definitely do. Alright, that's a decent fish. That's a decent fish. Could have a keeper here. I don't know. Oh yeah, that's a keeper. Oh wow, good size male. Oh, heck yeah. Measure him up just to make sure. Sixteen. Barely, but he is 16. And I'll take him. It's right at the at the end of the tide. It's pretty much dead slack now, I think. Low tide. And I thought I was snagged. Which I was, actually, but came out. Didn't bring up the bait all the way, just let it down there, and sure enough, he was on it. So, that's cool. Got a dinner fish. Now we're just gonna have some fun. What the heck? It's gotta be a foul hook. It's so very weird. Oh, that's an oyster toad. Still good. Decent fish. Just so much more fun finding these things in deeper water. Nice female. Whoa, 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 whoa. A lot of spunk. It's probably 14. She gave a pretty good fight though. It's great that I'm holding bottom with such small weight too. That's really, I mean, not only is it fun, but it just makes it easier to catch them and feel the bite. I'll see when the current switches directions. Probably gonna have to go to a bigger size. Whoa. They're just on it as soon as it hits the bottom. I'm gonna have to put the underwater down. Oh my goodness. Watch this. Bigger than I thought. Just such a cool fish. So, this is the fuzz I'm always trying to talk about. That's what you want to see. Once you start seeing fuzz like that, that means something's going on. Gotta remember to turn the drag bag on. And I took it. It's really a timing thing. It's not even that you have to set hard. It's all timing. Once you figure out once what the hit is when they have it. Whoa. On. Some good sized fish. Whoa. Oh. This is definitely a better start than last year. For sure. Just don't be afraid to give them a little check. Because they like to hit it after it comes back down. You don't have to keep it super still, you really don't. There, 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 there. Not yet, not yet. There! Just see the movement. Small. Ooh. That's the right hook set that you want to see though. He fully had that jig. Gee. Alright, we're gonna practice more underwater now.
Alright, so here we go. Remember, it's pretty deep, it's about 40 to 50 feet, so the clarity isn't great, but this is actually really good without a use of a light. And yeah, you're gonna see right away, you know, some clouds from the weight hitting the bottom. See the current moving not too fast, and you're gonna see blackfish, decent sized ones, already taking the bait. You know, this is after I've already been fishing for a while, so they're pretty fired up, they're ready to go. And watch, this one even follows it all the way up probably a good 10 feet off the bottom and takes it. This clip is really cool, and I slow it down so that you can see this blackfish actually come out of his crevice right there. Pretty amazing how tightly packed they can get in between these rocks. They definitely love tightly packed rocks. Pretty cool here to see how different the color contrast is between these two fish. One right there on the left is just so much lighter than the other one. As you can see, the bottom next to the rocks is not really gray. It's just like a sandy, silty bottom. But these rocks are definitely enough to give them a lot of cover. And, you know, there's a lot of fish at this little oasis. And you're going to see right here that I think I count about like eight fish right here in this freeze frame, which is pretty amazing to see that many blackfish. So although a lot of these fish will run away with the jig, you can see a bigger one here kind of just suck it in and hold it there. This is also what I've found happens a lot of times with some bigger fish, is the bite is very subtle where they'll actually pick up the jig. And you'll see this actually later in the video too. This fish actually measured under 16 inches. He was probably about 15 and a half, just for perspective. Here's just a different angle of the bottom. Hard to see really, but you can just tell this is definitely a decent pile of rocks, and there's a lot of decent sized fish just swimming in and around these rocks. I cut this little section here just to show you that sometimes they swim pretty high off the bottom. This guy just kind of cruising along. Just found that kind of interesting. Did see something like that too on the previous video in the sound. So here I put two pieces of crab on the hook, one with the shell on and some legs, and one without the shell. And you can see this guy clearly wants the easier meal, which is the piece without the shell or the legs. I don't know, this is just one time, but it is interesting that they do seem to want the easier meal. Or maybe it's the color. Who knows? So at this point, the bite is slowing down a little bit, but the fish are still down there. You can just see how they're, you know, taking their time, looking at the bait a little longer. There's a big one there. You know, after looking at this footage, it almost seems to me that some of the bigger ones know the crab is on a hook, but they're willing to try and take it off of the hook. They think they're actually smarter than the fishermen. This was a good sized fish, but he was actually under 16 inches, just under 16 inches. This is a pretty good sized tog, I think probably 16 or 17, but it's amazing how long he looks at this crab, and you're going to see in a second here that he even just grazes it and touches it with its lip. There it is, just to kind of see what's going on. It's pretty amazing to just see how much they really look at that bait. And I think that's why sometimes you actually really do want to let your crab just sit there, even if you haven't felt any bites. Make sure there's still crab there, but you definitely want it to really sit there for a while so they get more and more curious and eventually will take it.
So, bite kind of shut off as the current started picking up. Just messing around with the underwater. With the light, it's getting a little more challenging now to do the underwater with the current, and so I'm switching back to fishing for a bit, see if I can get the bite going again. I'm using a 1.5 ounce jig and I'm barely holding bottom, so it's getting a little more difficult. It's got those bigger head shakes. Not really making a run. Okay, never mind. Whew. good sized tot. Solid 17. All right, I'm gonna keep him. Actually, cause I got someone who would love to have one of these right now. Smart. It was like the first drop they were like stupid, but now they wised up. So if you watch closely here, you can see the weight actually get lifted up right there. Oh, good fish. Good fish. That's good fish. Lucky to get him. Whew. Wow, that's my limit. I'm gonna actually take all three of these fish, because I don't think I'm gonna be able to get out again. And I know people who would happily. That was a fun fight. 18. Fought like a 20 incher. He's 18 though. Yeah. Solid, solid fish. Whew. Thank you, Lord. That's awesome. That was awesome. Man, he scraped me up on so much down there. That's why I use mono and not fluoro. I bet you fluoro would have broke off. Mono's so much better. Unbelievable. Ended up with a 16, 17, and 18. Well, I'm gonna pretty much head in now then. It's my limit. I'm very happy with that. Crazy.
All right, so that's gonna wrap it up. It's a great day. One of the best days out here in the Sound that I've had. And a really awesome bite in the beginning. Caught one keeper in the beginning and then did some underwater, and then the bite kind of slowed as the current changed and I had to kind of reposition myself. I did, and then the bite was slow, but waded through it and they started coming back. And yeah, just caught two really nice fish there at the end, 17 and an 18 inch fish. So they were still there. It's just, the bite wasn't like furious, but just waited all those little bites out, kind of get them going. And then like that last one picked up the jig, and I love that. I love when they pick up the jig, you just know you got a big fish when you set the hook on that lift. So a lot of fun. He pulled a lot of drag. It was a lot of fun. Glad I got him. The leader chafed quite a bit, but we got him, and that was only, I think, 20 pound mono leader, so yeah, pretty thankful to get that guy in. And yeah, so thanks for tuning in. I may do another episode, but this may be this season for a little bit. I don't know how many more days, you know, I can get out here without a dry suit, so. Alright. See you later, and catch you next time.
What did you put in that one,
baby? I don't know. No butter or anything. Crushing it, man. Crushing it. Okay, 1 second.
Did he eat
a lot? Yeah, he's eating a lot. Oh my goodness.
Peter, you come to daddy.
Okay, no, that's fine. Whoops. Are you done? One more? It's the last one. All right, that's it.